Do you feel that this place, this church that you love, came pretty darn close to becoming Newtown?
Absolutely. 101%. Absolutely.
Vince Harrison was staring at the gunman, 15-year-old Nehemiah Griego, who early Saturday morning, according to detectives, had just massacred his entire family and planned to continue killing until the police killed him. Oddly enough, the former Albuquerque police officer was actually leading a drill on what to do when a shooter is loose in a church when he came face to face with the reality.
Thinking about it, does this hill send chills up my spine? I'm not sure if he came here for help. This is what he knew. This was his life away from his home.
A home life that was hard, according to neighbors who said the shooter's father, Greg Griego, practiced tough love.
I think he was a tyrant. And the kids under that type pressure, I didn't see any sign of love among those people.
The heartbreaking details of what happened in the Griego home start with young Nehemiah arguing with his mother, according to detectives, who say when she went to sleep, the 15-year-old took his father's .22 caliber rifle and shot her in the head. That woke up his brother. Investigators say Griego lifted his dead mother's head and showed it to 9-year-old Zephania before killing him as well. Investigators say his 5-year-old sister, JL, and the youngest member of the family, 2-year-old Angelina, were next. At this point, the investigators say Griego changed weapons and waited hours until his father, Greg, came home. Detectives say the one-time gang member and now pastor was shot in the back and killed with his own AR-15. Investigators believe the boy wasn't done yet, saying he reloaded the AR-15 and the .22 caliber rifle and put them with more ammo into the family minivan. Investigators say he wanted to come to this Walmart. Why? According to the criminal complaint, to murder more people in a populated area and then die in a gunfight with police. But for some reason, the teen changed his mind and instead drove to his family's church. Griego left the guns in the van and went inside, where he spent the day like an average teenager, hanging out with his girlfriend at the church's skate park, the basketball courts, and bookstore. The first sign of trouble at the megachurch was when Pastor Justin Marbury was told by a parishioner that something was wrong with Griego's family, so he asked the 15-year-old if he knew anything.
What he was saying was, my family's dead.
Griego told the pastor and Vince Harrison he had actually been home and discovered his dead family, but for some reason did not call police.
Just his behavior was real quiet and cold and a matter of fact. And the red flag started going up.
Harrison and the pastor decided to take Griego to his house to see if his story was true. But a mile from the house, Harrison felt something he hadn't since his days as a homicide cop.
Something evil was not right. Felt like a darkness.
He pulled over and got out of the car so Griego couldn't hear him call 911. Sheriff's deputies met them at the house. They used Griego's key and found the bodies. Deputies arrested the teen quietly. Authorities say he eventually confessed and told officers he started his killing spree because he was angry with his mother. Griego seemed disconnected, say officers, only getting excited when he talked about his love of violent video games. A stunning turn for his church community, who saw the youngster grow up as a normal child until the day of the murders.
Part of what I do as a pastor is I'm watching out for the church, for the people here, and part of that is paying attention.
Do you think paying attention made a difference here?
I think taking it seriously and following through did, yeah.
The difference between a family tragedy and what could have been another Newtown. Kyung Law, CNN, Albuquerque, New Mexico. Such an